Almost half the stores stand empty. Daycare centres don't have enough children, and businesses can't find enough skilled workers. A small town in the German state of Saxony, Mittweida, has lost over 5,000 inhabitants since German reunification. Those who have left are, above all, young and well-educated.
We're seeing it everywhere in our city. Construction sites are at a standstill because of a lack of materials. Machines are being dismantled here and shipped abroad to where the skilled workers are.
Hier mittlerweile abgebaut werden und ins Ausland verlagert werden, weil dort die Fachkräfte sind.
My name is Ralf Schreiber. I'm the mayor of Mittweida. And yes, we are facing a shortage of skilled workers here in Mittweida, like in many other cities.
Mayor Schreiber will stop at nothing. He has invited companies from different sectors that are urgently looking for skilled workers to a mayor's breakfast. There are also 180 job seekers invited by the Federal Employment Agency. They have 10 minutes to chat, and if things go well, this speed date could become a lasting relationship.
At the moment, we're currently missing 30 to 40 drivers. We're currently looking for about 5 to 6 people. The search is quite broad, from truck drivers to backhoe operators, stone splitters, accountants, controllers, everything.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 were here and introduced themselves. Around 7 to 8 would like to apply for a job with us.
And how many of them were registered elderly care nurses or medical nurses?
None.
No formal training. This is a problem employers know all too well. What's more, while most applicants from abroad already have a qualification, it first has to be officially approved.
I just had a very nice conversation with an applicant from Ukraine, a nurse who has several years of experience which is yet to be recognized.
Not all job seekers who received an invitation came, and even for those who did come, it wasn't always a good fit.
We've been looking for a very, very long time. It's difficult to find a job. Unfortunately, I don't have a driver's license. Nowadays, you're forced into it. But you don't get any assistance. You're left on your own. And so I'm looking for a glimmer of hope to finally make my dream come true.
What is your dream?
To be a truck driver. I've been looking for a number of years. So far, I haven't found the right fit. Last year, I got a caregiver's license, and I'm looking for something in that field.
It must be well paid. I get by all right with government assistance, but I can't afford a car.
The German labor market will lose 7 million workers by 2035. Ralf Schreiber has been mayor of Mittweida for 9 years. He's doing everything he can to lift up his small town. One important project for him has been the renovation of the town's shopping district. He wants to make it a lively place again, with benches and trees paved with granite mined right here in Mittweida.
We have a quarry in Mittweida, but the quarry doesn't have any workers, so we had to renegotiate our contract. Now we are only using Mittweida granite as far as Post Street, and then sadly, I must say, it's Chinese granite. Here's the border. Up to here is Mittweida granite. Then it's China, or Chinese granite.
We visit the quarry with Mayor Schreiber. He had been so pleased that a local company won the contract to pave the shopping street. So it was painful when managing director André Knipfer had to call off the contract because of a lack of manpower.
Aber irgendwann war die Situation.
But at some point it became clear that we wouldn't make the deadline. We tried using temp workers and subcontractors. We drove stones to a nearby town to have them processed. We drove stones to Poland, and I still haven't gotten them back. We simply lack the workforce to keep the machines that we have running at full capacity. That is our issue.
Thomas Wender has been working as a stone splitter for 25 years. To this day, it still requires manual labor. To split a stone correctly, you need experience and physical fitness. The quarry needs 6 stone splitters, but for some time now, there have only been 3.
Nobody really wants to do it. It's dirty, hard, loud, and frightens many. But it doesn't bother me.
For André Knipfer, however, it is a tricky problem. If he is short on tradesmen and skilled workers, the machines and excavators will grind to a halt.
Unfortunately, this means we can only handle 50% of all orders. We could do more. That's why we're desperately looking for people. The orders are there, the work is there. We could actually produce more than we are right now.
And this is not an isolated story. In Germany, there is currently a shortage of around 250,000 craftsmen, and that number is rising. For Mayor Schreiber, the shortage is even being felt in his city administration. He can no longer find tradespeople or engineers.
If we send over 50% of our young people into higher education and tell them that this is more important than local production, then we have a problem. That's why I think it's time to take a step back and ask, does everyone really need to be highly qualified in the future?
Yes,
we are a high-tech nation, but shouldn't we also value this kind of work? Where you can walk down a street and see the fruits of your labor.
The area around Mittweida is gorgeous, ideal for hikers, cyclists and anyone who loves the water. One tourist highlight is the Kriebstein Dam, with the only lakeside theater in Saxony. 6 excursion boats operate regularly every season, but then one of the skippers retired.
Last year, we didn't know whether we would have a skipper for the coming season. In other words, we were faced with a situation where a ship might just sit idle. It's seasonal work, and that's challenging because you don't get a day off. And it's hard to recruit people when you tell them that they have to work their way up, step by step, first on the ferry, then later on a passenger ship.
Steffi Brandl is a division manager here, and she knows how hard the tourism industry is. She is advocating for a new approach. She wants to be more welcoming to those seeking to change careers, with few qualifications, without a driving license or only basic German.
For example, when Ukrainians with some sort of training come here, I think Germany often shoots itself in the foot. Will those certificates or training documents be accepted? How long does it take for them to get work? That is one of the problems today. There was someone who worked as a skipper on a merchant ship, but now lives in Burgstedt. Couldn't we offer them some assistance? We're looking for workers everywhere, and it's sometimes a real struggle.
Every year, Germany needs 400,000 immigrants for its labor market. The shortage of skilled labor could have serious consequences, especially in the care sector. Here, nurses are being trained in Mittweida by Pflegeservice Wirz. They need at least 130 registered nurses to care for those patients who require assistance with respiration. A demanding task that requires proper training. When looking for staff, Uwe Wirz looks abroad.
Ich bin selbst in Vietnam gewesen.
I went to Vietnam myself and canvassed the language schools there.
Schulen habe ich mich umgesehen.
I visited countless places there, and one young man came back with me. He immediately said, I've decided here and now, I want to go to Germany for training. And that's what happened. He has since completed his training with very good grades, good language skills, and he now works for us. Where else will it come from? The only solution I see is immigration.
But not everyone agrees. In Midweida, many people vote for the right-wing populists who rail against migrants. When it comes to attracting good people to Germany, these two men fear Germany won't be able to compete.
We have to ask the question, why would someone from a country in Asia want to come to Germany? England is also in need of people, and English is much easier to learn.
In England werden auch Leute gesucht.
And guess what? They're also looking for people in Canada, too, and in America, and in France, and Italy. We're not doing enough at the moment.
Da müssen wir uns schon mehr anstrengen als das, was jetzt passiert.
Ralf Schreiber is a member of the Christian Democratic Union. In Saxony, the CDU is facing stiff competition from the far-right party Alternative for Germany. And migration is a topic they have sometimes struggled with.
Of course, we're very conservative. Up until a few years ago, the question of foreigners was not a topic for us. But now that's different. We have to shift our way of thinking. We have to accept that we have a labor problem and that we're experiencing a demographic shift. And that simply means we need skilled workers. We need people to work here.
But the mood of political debate has deteriorated, says Mayor Schreiber. Sometimes he is even threatened by people in the middle of the street. And yet,
I've enjoyed my job since day one. It offers a lot of variety. I enjoy communicating with people, and I don't let things like being attacked knock me off course. On the contrary, it motivates me to maintain a dialogue. And I get so much positive feedback that I'm able to just shrug off the odd negative comment. On the whole, it's positive.